Endocrine diseases. Some of the endocrine diseases are as follows. Deficiency of growth hormone in children leads to dwarfism. Hypersecretion of growth hormone in children, gigantism. Deficiency of growth hormone in adults, Simmons disease. Deficiency of growth hormone in children, dwarfism. Hypersecretion of growth hormone in children, gigantism. Deficiency of growth hormone in adults, Simmons disease. Hypersecretion of growth hormone in adults, acromegaly. Deficiency of thyroxine in children, cretinism. Deficiency of thyroxine in adult, myxedema. Hypersecretion of growth hormone in adults, acromegaly. Deficiency of thyroxine in children, cretinism. Deficiency of thyroxine in adults, myxedema. Hypersecretion of thyroxine, Graves' disease. Deficiency of glucocorticoids from adrenal, Addison's disease. Hypersecretion of glucocorticoids from adrenal, Cushing disease. Hypersecretion of thyroxine, Graves' disease. Deficiency of glucocorticoids from adrenal, Addison's disease. Hypersecretion of glucocorticoids from adrenal, Cushing disease. Deficiency of insulin from pancreas, diabetes mellitus. Deficiency of vasopressin, diabetes insipidus. Deficiency of parathormone, tetany. Deficiency of insulin from pancreas, diabetes mellitus. Deficiency of vasopressin, diabetes insipidus. Deficiency of parathormone, tetany. Disease is caused by addictive substances. Tobacco causes mouth cancer, peptic ulcer, and lung diseases like bronchitis, laryngitis, emphysema, and chronic cough. Tobacco causes mouth cancer, peptic ulcer, and lung diseases like bronchitis, laryngitis, emphysema, and chronic cough. Alcohol causes cirrhosis, which is damage to the liver, gastritis, peptic ulcers, pancreatitis, neuritis, heart disorders, and atherosclerosis. Narcotic drugs cause damage to nervous system, respiratory tract, and other organs. Cancer is an uncontrolled, unorganized, and abnormal division of the cell, forming a mass or group of undifferentiated malignant cells. Cancer is an uncontrolled, unorganized, and abnormal division of cell, forming a mass or group of undifferentiated malignant cells. Some of the cancers are as follows. Epithelial tissue. Cancers for epithelial tissue is called carcinoma. Cancer for epithelial tissue is called carcinoma. Cancer for connective tissue and muscular tissues can be called sarcoma. Cancers for lymph nodes and spleen, lymphoma. Leukocytes of blood, leukemia. Cancer for glands called adenoma. Adenoma is a cancer for glands. Leukemia is a cancer for leukocytes of blood, lymphoma, the cancer for lymph nodes and spleen, and sarcoma is the cancer for connective and muscular tissue. Carcinomas are considered as cancers for epithelial tissue. And let's see some immunological disorders. What you considered as autoimmune disorder. A person may develop autoimmunity against tissue or organs or secretions of its own body, which means immune system reacts against our own tissues. Example, Hashimoto's thyroiditis. Hashimoto's thyroiditis is an autoimmune disorder where antibodies are produced in a person's body against his own thyroglobulin. In such person, the glandular tissue of thyroid is lost and replaced by lymphoid tissue. So, Hashimoto thyroiditis is a disease. Antibodies are produced in a person's body against his own thyroglobulin. In such persons, the glandular tissue of thyroid is lost and is replaced by lymphoid tissue. And rheumatoid arthritis is also one of the autoimmune disorder which we consider rheumatoid arthritis as painful joints. Let's see the disease-causing agents. Any substance which causes disease is called disease-causing agent or etiological factor. The study of disease, study of cause of disease is called etiology. The study of cause of disease is called etiology. There are four major types of disease-causing agents as follows. Physical agents, chemical agents, mechanical agents, biological agents. In them, let's see physical agents. Physical agents include exposure to excess heat causing a stroke, excess cold causing frostbite, radiation causing cancer like strontium 90 cause bone cancer, excess sound causing impaired hearing, which we call physical agents, like excess heat, excess cold, radiation, and excess sound are called physical agents. Then let's see chemical agents. Some chemical compounds are also causative agents of certain diseases. There are two types: endogenous chemical agents, exogenous chemical agents. Internal chemical agents are produced in the body as a result of derangement of function, that like urea in the blood, we called uremia. Serum bilirubin, which leads to the jaundice. Uric acid, that accumulation of the uric acid cause gout. Calcium carbonate crystals in the kidney can cause the kidney stones. So uremia, which we call physiological uremia, that means blood urine. Serum bilirubin accumulation in the blood cause jaundice, and uric acid crystals can cause gout. Calcium carbonate crystals in the kidney cause kidney stones, are considered as endogenous chemical agents. Endogenous chemical agents. And then let's come through the exogenous chemical agents. External chemical agents enter the body by inhalation, ingestion, or inoculation. Exogenous chemical agents enters the body by inhalation, ingestion, or inoculation to cause diseases. Environmental pollutants, one of the example like dust, gases, insecticides, and pollen grains, heavy metals, addictive substances like tobacco, alcohol, and drugs are the exogenous chemical agents we call. Mechanical agents. Exposure to the chronic friction and other mechanical forces may result in crushing. Exposure to the chronic friction and other mechanical forces may result in crushing, like sprains, dislocation, fractures, that can be caused by the mechanical forces. We call them as mechanical agents. And let's see the biological agents, the fourth one here. The pathogens are microorganisms like bacteria, viruses, protozoans, helminths, and fungi, which cause diseases. They show properties like infectivity, ability to infect host, and pathogenicity, ability to induce illness. These pathogens enter the body, produce toxins during incubation period, which interferes with the normal functioning of the body and causes diseases. Biological agents, which are said to be the infectious agents, it may be a bacteria or virus or protozoan or helminth or fungi, which are causing the diseases, which are interfering the normal body functioning and cause the illness in the body. Among them, let's see bacterial agents. Unicellular prokaryotic organisms with cell wall, we call them as bacteria. Most bacteria make up the normal flora of the host and are harmless. Friendly germs, we call them as. Some like Streptococcus pneumoniae may grow in the throats of healthy people with a harmless commensal relationship most times. Streptococcus pneumoniae may grow in the throats of healthy people with a harmless commensal relationship. Only a minority of the bacteria are pathogens that cause infectious diseases. Robert Koch, a German physician, showed that the anthrax of sheep was caused by bacterial infection. The disease tuberculosis is named Koch disease after him. Robert Koch also established Koch postulates, basically a procedure to determine whether a certain organism is a source of particular infection. The Koch postulates are, you can see, find and isolate pathogen from host, grow pathogen in pure culture, introduce in a new host to produce same symptoms, isolate pathogen from the new host. The Koch postulates, find and isolate pathogen from host, grow pathogen in pure culture, introduce in a new host to produce symptoms, isolate pathogen from the new host. These are called Koch postulates. Some of the bacterial diseases are given here. Let's see. Tuberculosis, Koch disease. Tuberculosis is also called Koch disease. That is Mycobacterium tuberculosis. Leprosy, considered as Hansen's disease. Bacteria, Mycobacterium leprae. Tetanus, called lockjaw. Clostridium tetani. Botulism, food poisoning. Clostridium botulinum. Diphtheria, Corynebacterium diphtheria. Pneumonia, Streptococcus pneumonia. Whooping cough, we call pertussis. Bordetella pertussis. Bacillary dysentery, Shigella. Bacillary dysentery, Shigella. And infective diarrhea, Campylobacter jejuni. Infective diarrhea, Campylobacter jejuni. Typhoid, enteric fever, Salmonella typhi or Salmonella paratyphi A and B. Cholera, Vibrio cholera. Syphilis, Treponema pallidum. Gonorrhea, Neisseria gonorrhea. Sexual transmitted disorder it is. Urinary tract infection, women suffer more than men here because of Escherichia coli, yeast candida and Klebsiella. Anthrax, Bacillus anthracis, plague, Yersinia anthracis. Boils and pimples, Eosinia, Staphylococci. So the disorders, bacterial disorders, Mycobacterium tuberculosis, which cause tuberculosis, Mycobacterium leprae, leprosy, tetanus, lockjaw, Clostridium tetani, Clostridium botulinum, cause botulism, Corynebacterium diphtheria, diphtheria, Streptococcus pneumoniae, pneumonia, Bordetella pertussis, whooping cough, Shigella, bacillary dysentery, Campylobacter jejuni, infective diarrhea, Salmonella typhi and Salmonella paratyphi A and B cause typhoid, Vibrio cholera, cholera, Treponema pallidum, syphilis, Neisseria gonorrhea, gonorrhea, urinary tract infection caused by a bacteria Escherichia coli and also some of the yeast like Candida, Klebsiella are cause urinary tract infection, Bacillus anthracis, anthrax, Yersinia anthracis, plague, boils and pimples, Eosini, are caused by Staphylococci. Protozoan agents, unicellular eukaryotic microorganisms that lack cell walls are called protozoans. Some of the diseases caused by protozoans are amoebic dysentery, amoebiasis, causative protozoan, Entamoeba histolytica, pyuria, gum disease, Entamoeba gingivalis, African sleeping sickness, Trypanosoma gambiense, Kala-Azar, leishmaniasis, or oriental sores, Leishmania donovani, malaria, Plasmodium vivax, viral agents. The viruses are obligatory parasitic microorganisms without cells. They have nucleic acid with a protein coat. They are on the threshold of life. They are highly host specific. Common cold caused by a group of rhinoviruses, swine flu, H1N1 virus, influenza, orthomyxovirus, mumps, infectious parotitis, paramyxovirus, yellow fever, flavivirus, chickenpox in children or shingles in adults, varicella, zoster. Smallpox, variola, variola virus, measles, rubella, morbilli virus, poliomyelitis, polio virus, rabies, hydrophobia, rhabdovirus, AIDS, HIV, retrovirus we call, hepatitis A, B, C, D and E, hepatitis virus A, B, C, D and E respectively, Burkitt lymphoma, Epstein-Barr virus, common cold, rhinovirus, swine flu, H1N1 virus, influenza, arthromyxovirus, mumps, infectious parotitis, paramyxovirus, yellow fever, flavivirus, chickenpox in children and shingles in adult, varicella, zoster, smallpox, variola virus, measles, morbilli virus, poliomyelitis, poliovirus, rabies, rhabdovirus, AIDS, HIV, retrovirus, hepatitis A, B, C, D and E are caused by A, B, C, D and E hepatitis virus respectively. Burkitt's lymphoma, Epstein-Barr virus. Helminthus agents. Helminthus may be flatworms or roundworms which cause diseases. Belongs to both platyhelminthus and nematoda. Disease teniasis, neurocysticercosis. Causative helminth, Tinea solium, pork tapeworm, Tinea saginata, beef tapeworm, both are the parasites of human intestine. Ascariasis, Ascaris lumbricoides, filariasis, or elephantiasis, Sucuraria bancrofti. Fasciolasis, Fasciola hepaticus, liver fluke, it's an alternative host is a snail. And symptoms like diarrhea, anemia, liver damage, lowered body resistance. Schistosomiasis, Schistosoma monsoni, hookworm infection, ankylostoma duodenale. Teniasis, Tinea solium or pork tapeworm, Tinea saginata or beef tapeworm. Ascariasis, Ascaris lumbricoides. Filariasis or elephantiasis, Sucuraria bancrofti. Fasciolasis, Fasciola hepaticus, liver fluke. Schistosomiasis, Schistosoma monsoni, blood flu, hookworm infection, ankylostoma duodenale. Fungal agents. Fungi are eukaryotic, multicellular, saprophytic organisms that can cause disease. Fungi cause disease through three mechanisms. Immune response, causing allergic reactions like aspergillus. Producing endotoxins, called mycotoxins. Liver cancer is caused by aflatoxin produced by aspergillus flavus. Through infections causing mycosis. Some of the diseases caused by fungi are ringworm, Tinea corporis. Athlete's foot, Tinea pedis. Genital itch, Tinea cruris. Barber's itch, Tinea barbei. Onychomycosis, Tinea angium, are caused by the fungi like dermatophytes, like species of trichophyton, species of epidermophyton and species of microsporum. Actinomycosis, abscesses in the mouth and lungs, that caused by species of actinomyces. Blastomycosis, species of blastomyces dermatitis. Gilchrist disease we call blastomycosis as. Coccidiomycosis, California fever, that caused by species of Coccidiodes. Trichophyton, epidermophyton, microsporum are the fungi which cause the skin disorders called ringworm, athlete's foot, genital itch, barber's itch, onychomycosis. And actinomyces cause actinomycosis, abscesses in the mouth and lungs. Blastomyces, dermatitis cause blastomycosis, Gilchrist disease. Coccidiodes cause coccidiomycosis, California fever. Rickettsial agents. Rickettsias are prokaryotes included in proteobacteria and are intermediate between viruses and bacteria. Rickettsias are prokaryotes included in proteobacteria and are intermediate between viruses and bacteria. They are gram-negative, oval to rod-shaped and non-motile obligatory intracellular parasites. Most of them live in the intestines of insects. Rickettsias are mainly diseases caused by various rickettsial organisms as follows. Typhus fever by Rickettsia provojiki, Rocky Mountain Spotted Fever, Quarry Fever, Q fever we say, Trench Fever. These are all rickettsias, we say, rickets caused by rickettsial agents. Let's take a glance look on modes of transmission of diseases. The modes of transmission of diseases. Communicable diseases may be transmitted from an infectious person to a susceptible healthy person. The mode of transmission of these diseases depends upon infectious agent, way of entry, and local ecological conditions. Study of mode of transmission of disease is called epidemiology. Study of mode of transmission of disease is called epidemiology. There are two modes of transmission, direct transmission and indirect transmission. In this type, direct transmission, pathogens are directly transmitted without an intermediate agent. Direct transmission can take place by droplet infection, direct contact, soil contact, animal bite, and through placenta. Let's see droplet infection of direct transmission. The direct exposure of a healthy person to the droplets of saliva and nasopharyngeal secretions during coughing, sneezing, speaking, and spitting of infected person. There are more common in crowded and congested living conditions. Some of the examples for droplet infection are tuberculosis, diphtheria, mumps, common cold, whooping cough, pneumonia, and direct contact. Contagious diseases are directly transmitted from source to susceptible individual by handshake, mouth to mouth, kissing, and prolonged close contact and intimate sexual contact. Sexually transmitted disease, leprosy, skin and eye infections, ringworm, chickenpox, smallpox, measles, like Entamoeba gingivalis, they all come by direct contact. Sexually transmitted diseases are also known as venereal diseases. These are the diseases which are predominantly spread by sexual contact. Let us see some of the sexual transmitted diseases here, as Treponema pallidum is a bacterial bacteria which cause syphilis. Neisseria gonorrhoeae cause gonorrhea. Conchoid, Haemophilus doucerii. Conchoid is a bacterial STD that disorder caused by Haemophilus doucerii. Vaginitis, Chlamydia trachomatis. Viral STD, Herpes genitalis, caused by herpes simplex virus. Condyloma acuminatum, human papilloma virus. Condyloma acuminatum, causative organism, human papilloma virus. Molluscum contagiosum virus. AIDS, HIV 1 and HIV 2, as one of the protozoal sexual transmitted disorder is trichomoniasis, caused by Trichomonas vaginalis. In the direct transmission, the third one is contact with the soil. The infection acquired by the direct exposure to the disease agent in soil, a compost or decaying vegetable matter in which it normally leads to a saprophytic life, like hookworm larvae, tetanus bacteria, mycosis causing fungi. These are all by contact with the soil directly transmitted to the human beings. Next, animal bite. Animal bite causes inoculation of diseases causing agent directly into the skin mucosa. Like rabies or hydrophobia in man is caused by a virus that is transmitted through a dog bite. The virus present in the saliva of the rabid animal like dogs, cats, bats, monkeys like, and enters the healthy person through the wound. It is the only communicable disease of man which is fatal if not treated immediately after infection. Psittacosis, a parrot fever, spreads to human beings through contact with infected birds. The fifth method in direct transmission, transplacental transmission, vertical transmission we say. Direct transmission of disease agent through mother's placenta to the fetus can also cause disease like syphilis, rubella, toxoplasma, hepatitis B, cytomegalovirus, herpes virus, varicella virus and AIDS. They are all transplacental transmission, mother to fetus through placenta. Then let's see the second method, indirect transmission. Pathogens are transmitted from infected to healthy individual through intermediate agents. This transmission include 5 F's, flies, fingers, fomites, food and fluid. Then let's come through the vector-borne diseases here. Vectors are carriers, are those animals which carry the pathogens from an infected person to another potential host. Some of the vectors that cause diseases are housefly, musca domestica, spread, cholera and typhoid. Female mosquito, female anopheles mosquito, that scientific name anopheles, which cause malaria. Female culex mosquito, that culex, filaria, filariasis. Female Aedes mosquito, Aedes aegypti, yellow fever and dengue fever. Sandfly, Plibotimus argentipus, Plibotimus is the scientific name, Kala Ajar and Oriental Sore. Rat flea, Xenophila chiophis, the scientific name, it cause bubonic plague. CC fly, Glacina pulpalis, African sleeping sickness. The ticks, Dermacentor, Rocky Mountain Spotted Fever. They cause redweed bug, Rhodinus and Triatoma, Chagas disease in South America, body louse, Pediculus humanus, endemic typhus, epidemic typhus, they cause ichmite, Sarcoptes scabies, ichmite, Sarcoptes scabies. Vector-borne diseases, transmission of infectious agent through the agency of water, food, blood or semen causes diseases like jaundice, hepatitis B, AIDS, polio. Raw cow's milk may contain bovine tuberculosis bacterium. Meat of pig infected with tapeworm is called measly pork. Airborne diseases. Diseases caused by particles of droplet nuclei and dust in air through coughing, sneezing, and splitting of infected person. Fomite-borne diseases. Contamination of articles of daily use can cause transfer of infectious agents between the healthy person and patient suffering from the respective diseases. These articles are referred to as fomites, like handkerchief, towels, clothes, utensils, toys, door handles, taps. In a hospital, these also include bed linen, covers, dressing materials, syringes and needles. Pseudomonas aeruginosa can spread by direct contact through infected bed linen, instruments, like it is one of the commonest agents for hospital acquired infection. Other diseases that can be caused by fomites are diphtheria, typhoid, leprosy, hepatitis A. Unclean hands and fingers. This may cause direct transmission of pathogen from hand to mouth. Ascariasis, typhoid, hepatitis A are the examples for this. So, indirect transmission include vector-borne diseases, airborne diseases, fomite-borne diseases, unclean hands and fingers, and direct transmission include droplet infection, direct contact, and contact with soil, animal bite, transplacental transmission or vertical transmission we see.